Hello and welcome to another video from the Dutch Watch Dude. Today I have a Casio HQ180W. The W stands, as far as I know, for the water resistance. And with this watch, the water resistance is 10 atmosphere, 10 bar, or if you want, 100 meters. And then we're talking about standing cold water. With other words, don't take your watch in a bubble bath 100 meters in a hot tub is also not recommended. Even most hot tubs are not that deep, but the 10 atmosphere is more or less an indication. You can swim with it, you can shower with it. Don't take a watch into the sauna, because there are not really watches that are made for that. Some watches will survive it, but there is a difference between surviving something and actually doing something that is good for the watch. This watch has a few nice features. For example, it is a hybrid watch. That means it's partly digital, partly analog. It has an hour hand and a minute hand. That means the seconds, if you really like to see them, you can, of course, because there are different settings. Let me see, it has a lot of settings. Here we go. Now, as you probably noticed, the digital time and the analog time is not synchronized. You can make it run pretty close the same. But as long as this watch is actually using two different, it is a little bit dark, I see. So I should skip the close-up. There are two different circuits in this watch. One that actually works for the, and here we go with some little light. And that makes a close-up also a lot better. The digital watch and the analog watch are two different circuits. That means they are both running on different batteries. That is also a thing. So it can be that one of the batteries will be empty, but it will take you 10 years. So it probably will not happen that fast. I'm going to turn the light off again, because this watch has, of course, a built-in light. The illuminator indication on the dial already did give that away, but you never have a problem reading the time in the dark. The watch does have some lume on the hands and on the indicator, but that is not the best lume in the market, so you probably will use the light button. But always keep in mind, light is actually using a really big amount of energy, so use it as less as possible, because yeah, the battery lasts 10 years, but not if you use the light very often. If you use it a few times a day, you will actually have the time of the battery life, then it will only last a few years. Like all watches, there is a lot written on the back. In this case, there is one thing kind of important. If you look to the little square, you see the indication 37.93. That is the actual movement inside of this watch. They call it the module. If you look at the Casio, Casio side, you really need that number if you want to set the time. I wanted to set the time a little bit earlier, before I was starting to make this video. And I find out that I had no clue how to set the analog hands. That is actually done by keeping one button. No, I'm wrong. Pushing the B button. This is the A button, the B button, the C button, and the D button. Very interesting. If you want to know it, but you find that in the manual. By pushing this button 6 times, you can actually get in some menu. You push the A button 1 time, and then you can, using the D button, to move the hands in steps of 20 seconds or you keep it pushed in and then it will start running slowly, but it will do a full 12-hour run in like 3 minutes. It only runs forward, so if you just have to put it 3 minutes back, like I had to do earlier, then you have to do the whole circle, and that takes quite a lot of time to set the watch. But if you set it right, it keeps on running. The crystal, it's probably acryl or acrylic. I'm not 100% sure how to pronounce that, but it's not glass. So if you have some scratches on it, you can just polish it out. It will not scratch easy because it has kind of a nice bezel to protect the glass. But if you use it as a work watch, you will get some scratches on it. The watch will set you back like 30 euros. So yeah, it's not that a big deal, I think, if you get some scratches on it. It's a real nice work watch. And it actually looks less nice than it is. I know that sounds a little bit strange, but if you look at the watch itself is steel, stainless steel. So that is a very good thing. The back is screwed and partly of the back is rubbery material. It same counts for the strap. The strap looks cheap, feels cheap, but as soon as you wear it, it actually wears quite nice. It doesn't bother me if I wear it. It feels kind of nice. There is a little thing, as you can see, if you want to replace the strap, you really need a Casio strap or a third party strap, specially made for this watch, because it will not take a regular strap. So you have to be careful a little bit with it, otherwise you have to hunt for a strap. And most of the time, those straps are quite expensive, and that is one of the setbacks of it. It feels quite nice on your wrist, so yeah, it doesn't look really expensive or really good, but it feels good, it works good. It's actually just a nice watch that probably gives a lot of watch for its money. You can a little bit compare it with the Chinese watches I have. You don't have to pay the whole world for just a nice watch that is doing the job it's supposed to do. Is there anything else I can tell about this watch? Probably not, so I will not bother you with things that are completely uninteresting. The only thing rest me to say is, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the channel, please follow me. Watch the other videos, and if you like watches, follow me on the Instagram, that's WatchDude. I hope to see you with another video very soon. Goodbye.